Variable sets are central to how Displayer works. And this video will help you understand what a variable set is, how they are structured, and how to manually define them. When you import a data file in Displayer, it's automatically converted to a data set. You can see that the name of this data set is COLA tracking, January to September, which is also the name of the data file that was originally imported. Each item listed makes up a separate variable set. A variable set is a group of one or more variables. These sets formed automatically when you imported the dataset into Displayer. When dragging a variable set onto the page, a table gets created. This is a summary table of the variable set called Brand Attitude. It comes from a question in a survey where we asked respondents whether they liked or disliked different brands of cola. Displayer has automatically structured this variable set and formatted it in a two-dimensional grid structure to show attitudes as percentages across six different brands. The specific name of this variable set structure is nominal multigrid. I'll click on the variable set name here on the left to make the structure appear in the object inspector on the right. Here, each row of the table is a nominal variable, which means each category is mutually exclusive and each brand sums to 100%. A nominal multigrid is just one of 13 variable set structures in Displayer. Before we visit those, let's take a look at the raw, unstructured data behind this table. To do that, right-click on the variable set and select Data Editor. As you can see, the data from the variable set for Brand Attitude contains five columns. The column headers contain the names of each variable within the set. The rows contain the case number, or respondent, and each cell contains the answer given. You can edit the raw data in this view. Looking at Brand Attitude in the Datasets tree again, you can click this triangle to expand the variable set. Here, you can see the six variables in this set. To edit the values and labels in this variable set, first click on the variable set so that the Values button appears in the Object Inspector. And then click on Values. You'll notice that the values for love and like are reversed. Since typically love would receive the highest value, I'll quickly edit the values between the two so that now love gets the highest value. You can merge categories by dragging and dropping and create nets by using the right click. Displayer remembers this and applies the change to anywhere you have used this variable set. However, if you don't want that change to be made everywhere, you can duplicate the variable set reset it so that the original categories are shown. Sometimes we might want to change the structure of a variable set. For example, we can change the structure of this variable set to numeric. So the summary table shows averages instead of percentages, and it now only shows one column. Displayer has 13 different types of variable set structures, and a different icon is used to represent each structure in the datasets tree. Let's look at a couple more examples. Date time measurement variables, like the interview data variable set, which is the summary table on the left, will show the proportion in an aggregated period when used in tables. Date time variable sets are special because you can easily change the aggregation or period by clicking the date time button in the object inspector, and Displayer will automatically recalculate the results. The main difference between cola drinkers is a text variable set and is shown in the summary table on the right. When used in a summary table, the raw or verbatim responses are shown. You can learn more about transforming text variable sets and our text categorization tools in our text analysis video. So far, we have looked at how variables in a data set are grouped into variable sets and how the structure of a variable set can be modified. In the underlying data file, each possible response is stored with a numeric value. For example, in this age variable set, if a survey respondent chose an age of 18 to 24, this may be stored as a value of 21 as a midpoint, and an age of 25 to 29 may be stored as a value of 27. To see which label is associated with which value, click on the variable set and then the values button in the object inspector. Here, you can change the labels, value, or include or exclude certain categories from the analysis to treat them as missing data. For example, if we want to exclude anyone over the age of 65, we exclude that category from the analysis. And as you can see, it's been removed from the table. Displayer will also automatically rebase the sample size. For more information and help on understanding the different combinations for count this value and missing value settings for other variable types, as well as more details for setting attributes on grids, please visit our Variable Sets article in the Help Center.